submitted matters under Standing Order 29A, which will be listed in the official debate. The matters raised by the following deputies have been selected for discussion. Deputy Jim O'Callaghan, they discussed the recent fatal shootings in Dublin. Deputies Jonas O'Brien, Louise O'Reilly and Donagh O'Leary to discuss staffing levels at St Finbar's Hospital in Cork. Deputies Catherine Connolly and Eamon O'Keefe to discuss the closure of time for use an access service for parents in Galway. And finally, Deputy Richard Boyd Barrett to discuss attempts to sell playing pitches and Clonkeen College. So we now move to leaders' questions, and I call on Deputy Timmy Dooley, who has 3 minutes.
Thanks very much. You'll be aware of the decision yesterday by AIR to withdraw from the government-sponsored national broadband plan. This follows a decision by CSIRO, a joint venture between the ESB and Vodafone, to withdraw from the same process late last year. In short, Minister, three of the most experienced and established utility companies in the state have opted out of the government process to provide broadband infrastructure to 542,000 homes and business premises dotted throughout rural Ireland. Your Fine Gael-led government back in 2011 promised that broadband would be rolled out to every premises in the state by 2016. That didn't happen, and yesterday's announcement signals, in my view, the collapse of your plan. Again, when you negotiated a programme for government, with Minister Nocton playing a key role, you indicated that by June of 2017, a deal would be done and a contractor would be appointed. That date was slipped. Virtually every date that you have set since talking about a national broadband plan has been missed. Minister Nocton, when asked repeatedly in this House to outline the projected contract signing dates, the dates for work to begin and work to be completed, has dodged the questions and instead waxed lyrically about all the broadband that's being rolled out throughout Ireland, failing, of course, to mention that it's being rolled out by commercial operators based on the commercial decisions of these telecom companies, and in many cases duplicating a service that already existed in densely populated areas. Don't forget, Tánaiste, in your role as a former Minister for Agriculture, you know the profile and character of rural Ireland. You know the kind of people that you've met on your visits there. You know the farming communities, you know the small communities, you know the small businesses that support farming, that require access to high-speed broadband. You know the people who live in rural Ireland, and you know the students who come home at weekend, come home from school every night. In order to be able to pursue their studies, they need access to broadband. People who live there need access to broadband to do their banking, to do their basic life pursuits. And they're being deprived, and they're being continuously deprived, and they've been sold a pup time after time. When Vodafone and ESB pulled out of this particular process, it should have raised a red flag in the department concerned, but it didn't. The withdrawal of AIR should have signalled a crisis with the process, but it hasn't. Minister Nocton, amazingly, has welcomed the clarity provided by the withdrawal of AIR. He believes that shovels will be in the ground more quickly, and that the project will now be delivered on budget and ahead of schedule. Tánaiste, what cyber galaxy is Minister Nocton living in? The situation is absolutely farcical at this stage. There are still months of detailed negotiations to take place between the remaining bidder and the government on pricing and indeed on technical matters. So there's no guarantee at all if a deal can be arrived at, or if the deal proposed by the government will remain viable for the 25 years of the contract. Now, the last thing that 542,000 homes and businesses need is another false dawn, or worse still, a contract that collapses a few years into operation. Minister Fianna Fáil previously proposed that this infrastructure should have been built by the state and owned by the state. The Minister rejected that proposition at the time, citing that it would create significant delays to the project. You put your faith in the market, and the market has turned its back on you. Minister, in light of what has happened, will the government now consider changing the nature of the tender so that the state will take responsibility for building this infrastructure and ultimately becoming the owner?
Tánaiste, 3 minutes.
Deputy, first of all, the government is acutely aware of the pressures in rural Ireland in terms of the need for broadband access. I, like many people in this house, grew up on a farm in a rural community. And I know the responsibility that the government has to make sure that people in rural Ireland, as well as people in urban centres, can access the information and the opportunity that the internet now provides, and needs speed to be able to do that, and by and large needs fibre to deliver that speed, which is exactly what the government is committed to delivering by effectively state sponsoring the rollout of broadband to the 500,000 or so households that currently don't have it. And we are going to see that through. We have been through a very complex tendering process to get there in terms of finalising a tender, which is a tender that's going to last for 25 years. That has been a competitive process. And like many competitive processes, Deputy, commercial operators pull out of them for commercial reasons if it doesn't suit them. And that's what's happened here. But we also have another operator, there is only one now left, who have been adamant that they are committed to this process, they want to work with the government on it, they think they can do it. And so your suggestion, Deputy, that the approach the government should take now, after all of the work that has been undertaken to date, there's about 80 people working on this for the state to get this contract right. We're expecting it to be concluded by September so that we can actually roll out the state sponsored broadband delivery rapidly after that, on top of what's already happening, by the way, commercially, which is about 300 farms a week if you want to raise agriculture, are getting access to broadband every week at the moment. And we want to accelerate that in parts of Ireland that don't have commercial solutions. But the idea that we should at this stage, because one operator has pulled out and we have another operator confirming that they want to get on and do the business, that actually we should stall the whole process and ask for another panel of experts to come in and make recommendations that would mean that nothing would happen probably for years and we'd start all over again, when the minister has assurance that actually we're almost where we need to be in terms of spending hundreds of millions of euros of taxpayers' money to make sure that rural Ireland gets the broadband that it needs. We are going to see this through. It has been complex and difficult, but we were only months away from approving a preferred bidder anyway before September. That has essentially been fast-forwarded now, and we need to work with ENET and the others in that consortium, who are big players in this sector, by the way. This isn't some kind of small operation. They are as big as the ESB are, or as big as some of the bidders that have pulled out.
It's not. Your time is expired.
SSE is not a tiny operation.
You'll have another minute. Tanisha, you'll have another minute.
They have.
And deputies,
so,
please.
So what I'm saying is the government is committed to doing this. Resources are not the problem here. Finalising a complex contract is the issue. And we hope to have that done by September, as opposed to the recommendations of others, it seems, today, to start all over again, which certainly is not what rural Ireland would thank us for.
Deputy Dooley has 1 minute.
And I know that if you go to the market with your bullock and there's only one person there to buy it, you'll take the price that they want to offer. And what you're now suggesting is that you somehow have the upper hand. You're at the market. There's only one person there. Your back's to the wall. So if you think you're going to be able to reach and achieve the deadlines that Minister Nocton keeps avoiding answering, or that somehow you're going to get value for money for the taxpayer, wake up, Minister. It's not going to happen. The fact of the matter is that the two companies with the greatest footprint in this state, with the greatest experience, the most established operators who understand the marketplace, have pulled out. If that's not plain to you and to the government that there's a serious problem with the contract and with the tender that you're proposing, well, then you really don't understand what's going on here. It's about time that you faced up to what's happening. People are deeply concerned now that the government are not even committed to providing broadband to those 540,000 homes. Because if you were, you would have treated this in an awful lot more serious matter. And of course, Minister Nocton will again use, we're putting broadband into 100 farms every week. Those that are on the edge of the villages that are being facilitated on a commercial basis. I'd suggest if the Minister is in any way disbelieving as to what I have, he should visit his constituency this weekend.
Tanisha.
First of all, can I just set the record straight on something? Because I think there's a bit of politics being played with this issue, because broadband is a...
Tánaiste Chair, was that interruption?
Broadband is a very emotive issue in rural Ireland, so it's easy, to raise concerns in relation to it. SSE are the second largest electricity supplier in the country. ENED is a very significant big fibre operator already in the country. We have a credible consortium who have already engaged with the department at length and submitted costings and proposals and so on. There was always going to be a preferred bidder at the end of this process that the state would need to negotiate and finalise contracts.
I'm going to move on.
And that is now what is going to happen. It's not like we're starting this process again with one bidder. The process is nearly concluded, and now we need to finalise it. And now it is.
Deputies,
it will
please.
Be concluded by September, Deputy. And we now have a bidder.
Deputies,
we now have a bidder who is anxious.
Deputy Donnelly. You might like the answers, but you have to listen to them. And I'm going to move on to Deputy Munster.
You don't want to hear the answers.
Bring your
That's the problem.
Bring your answers.
The government will see this through and we roll out
McGrath.
Fiber words.
Deputy McGrath. It's not your opportunity. It's been a false.